Okay, so you know what I just heard?
It's the Cooper and Anthony Show.
I've heard of them. They're famous.
That's right, Mike. They are.
Big story today out of New Zealand. And I love stories like this. This is kind of like one of my favorite type of stories. Because it's about food. Anybody who wants to write a story or post anything about food, you know that I am always a fan, always. In New Zealand, there's a couple that I guess they have a garden and they grew a potato. And when they looked at the potato, they realized the potato was nearly 18 pounds, which is, they said, the size of a newborn. But I don't know any newborns that are 18 pounds, more like a toddler.
No, that's like so, two kids or three kids even.
Right, if you have triplets. So because the potato is almost 18 pounds, they named him Doug.
I'm a potato.
Doug the potato.
Yeah, so of course, you know, in New Zealand, at least in the little town where they live, this is big news. this is like the news of the day. In fact, I think Guinness even showed up there. Not Guinness beer. I mean, I think you'd have to be drunk to be excited about a potato, but I think the Guinness Book of World Records went down there because I think this might be the largest potato that we've ever known.
I'm a potato.
So the guy who grew Doug was being interviewed, but I want you to pay close attention to this phrase that he uses, because I've never heard this before, and you could tell me what you think the phrase means.
I got the fork and jabbed into it and hoiked it out of the ground and holy snapping turtle teeth. What's going on here? I said to Don, no, that's a potato. And she went, no. I said, yeah, it is. Since I'm a bit of a hobbyist home brewer, I'm thinking about a special vodka.
So I think that's what he's going to do. I guess they asked him, how'd you find the potato and what are you going to do with it? So I think he's going to turn the potato into some vodka. But holy snappin' turtle teeth, what's going on here? That's the quote. Holy snappin' turtle teeth?
Have you ever heard that? I got the fork and jabbed into it and hoiked it out of the ground and holy snappin' turtle teeth. What's going on here?
What is this?
That's got to be an Irish term that only a certain town in Ireland uses.
But this is New Zealand.
Oh, okay. Same thing.
No, it's not. It's two completely different countries. And You know what? You don't make the mistake right now, because as you know, all the countries are over in Glasgow, Scotland, you know, having the big summit about climate change and all that other kind of stuff. And so far, everyone's gotten it wrong. Like Wolf Blitzer on CNN was like, here we are in Edinburgh. No, you're in Glasgow. Mm-hmm. Even Obama called it the Emerald Isles, but that's Ireland. This is Scotland and not quite the Emerald Isles.
So I'm in good company by getting it wrong.
You're in good company by thinking New Zealand is somewhere in Ireland. Yeah. I thought that expression was interesting. Holy snapping turtle teeth. So, you know me, I don't let anything go. So I had to go do like a deep dive into those kinds of phrases in other countries.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to tell you the language. I'm going to tell you the phrase, and you have to tell me what you think it means. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. In Swedish, there is a term. There's no cow on the ice.
There's no cow on the ice. That means it could break easy.
Right. So there's no cow on the ice. So what are they actually saying if there's no cow on the ice?
I have no freaking clue what that means.
Well, you were almost there. It means there's no need to worry. There's no cow on the ice, meaning the ice is not going to break, just as you were saying. The ice is not going to break. No need to worry.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, if you're in Sweden and you need to use a phrase, say there's no cow on the ice and nobody there will think you're insane.
And they think you're from there.
Right. Exactly. Also, a Swedish term that I think is interesting, to slide in on a shrimp sandwich. What does it mean when someone says they're about to slide in on a shrimp sandwich?
On the good life. They're coming in on the good life.
Wow. That's really good, because I heard that and I thought it was some kind of sexual term. I thought it was like somebody about to slide to someone's DMs. you know, think about slide into a shrimp sandwich, you know, like
no, because that's reference. Something that's been around for a long time. That's not a new saying. So the DMs didn't last back then. So, and I'm thinking that that shrimp is not cheap. So that's where I'm getting that from.
Well, I didn't mean slide into your DMs necessarily. I meant like I'm using the slang term. I mean, you know, you're about to get lucky is what I thought it meant. I'm about to slide in on a shrimp sandwich, you know. No, you're right. It means somebody who doesn't have to work to get where they are. Somebody who's has the easy life. That's very good. You did a good job there.
We say born with a silver spoon. They say shrimp sandwich.
Right. Exactly. If you're in Poland, let me just start by saying I have been saying this term. I didn't know where I got it from. And every time I say it, people are like, well, that's kind of clever. And I thought I was being clever. But apparently, this is a long-held term or slang in Poland.
Mm-hmm.
They go, not my circus, not my monkey.
Right. Not my pig, not my farm.
I've been saying not my circus, not my clowns. Sometimes I say monkey, sometimes I say clowns. Like, not my circus, not my clowns.
Mm-hmm.
So what do you think that means? I think it's obvious.
Yeah, that means it has nothing to do with me. I'm out.
It is not my problem. Exactly. Right. Yeah. I like that one. In Latvia, if you go to Latvia.
Don't think somebody... I ever will, but okay. Since I don't know where it is.
Okay. If you meet a hot chick who's mm-hmm. from Latvia. And she says that she doesn't want you to blow little ducks.
Blow little ducks. Okay.
She says she wants you to stop. Just don't blow little ducks. What do you think she's asking you not to do?
Worry about the little things, I guess.
Oh, my God. That's so good. Right. Don't talk nonsense. Don't BS me.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's really good. How about this in French? This one I should know because my family's French, but I've never heard this one before. To jump from the cock to the donkey.
Wow. Well, the cock is actually a bird. Uh-huh. So I'm thinking it's from jumping from a small animal to a big animal. So a small problem to a big problem.
You would think it would mean something. That's sort of logical. Like, I would think it would mean something like that. It actually means don't change topics without logic in a conversation. Like, you know, don't interrupt me. If I'm saying one thing, don't start going to something else.
Yeah, that's stupid.
I guess it's stupid, but yeah, I guess it happens a lot in France. Also a French one, to have the midday demon. What does that mean?
Must be alcohol related.
The midday demon, if you are French, actually refers to having a midlife crisis. He's having a midday demon, but they say it in French. La demon
makes
la
more demon, sense in French.
Le demon de midi is how they phrase it. Yeah. Let's see another duck one in Portuguese. If you pay the duck, what does that mean?
Pay the duck.
Pay the duck.
Pay the man. Give the man money. Pay the duck. Come on. Pay the duck.
It means to take blame for something you did not do.
I'm not paying the duck on that one.
Yeah.
Like that? Yeah. Okay.
You want a couple more?
I got a couple more. Bob's your uncle.
Okay. Well, that one, everybody knows Bob's your uncle. Do you know what that means, though?
I have no idea what Bob's your uncle means. Somebody told me once, but I forgot.
Okay. So, like, it's a term in England. If you go, you do this, you do that, and then Bob's your uncle. It basically means you do this, you do that, and then you're there. Then you're done. Then, you know, you've accomplished what it is you're trying to accomplish. Like, then Bob's your uncle.
Yeah, it makes no sense.
I don't know where it's from, but anyway. Let's find a good one. This is right. You'll like this. If you are among Hungarians and they say they chased me into the penis forest with my mouth wide open.
Wow.
I'll give you a hint.
Yeah, it means I'm screwed no matter what. Yeah,
yes. Exactly. It means that your boss basically gave you a task that is completely unreasonable, something that there's no way you can do it. Your boss chased you into the penis forest with your mouth wide open.
I'm using that one tomorrow.
Yeah. see how well that one goes over. Make sure you don't get called into HR.
Just saying. It's the Cooper and Anthony Show.
You got to tell me if this guy's brilliant or if this guy's insane.
Okay.
Okay, these two people are dating. Uh-huh. The girl said, okay, I'll go out on a date with you. Finally, she broke down and said, all right, you've swiped left, I've whatever. We matched. Let's go on a date. Mm. I want to get to know you better. So before the date, he sends her a Google form to fill out.
What?
Yeah, a Google form. And so she's got to fill this out before they go on a date. And I think it's freaking brilliant. And you tell me if you think it's brilliant or the guy's a whack job.
A friend of mine recently asked me out on a date, and after I said yes, he sent me a Google form. Let's go through it together, why don't we? First,
yes, please.
You've agreed to go on a date with Graham. Congratulations. He promises a good time with your preferences in mind. He asked me what my name is. I sure hoped he knew that answer. When I'd like to start the date, yeah. What style of date I'd prefer?
See?
Dinner and a movie is what I chose, because that's just what we had already decided.
Okay, so he's got dinner and a movie.
Wait, pause it. Yeah. Okay.
Dinner and Imagine Van Gogh, hike
or
outdoor option, beach day and ice cream, skating and hot chocolate, or a combination of any of the others. So it's kind of like a menu you get at a restaurant.
I love that. I would have chosen, I guess it depends on what time of year and what part of the country they live in. But, you know, who wouldn't go for beach and ice cream? That just sounds like a great day. Even if you hate the person, you're at the beach and you get ice cream. Like, win-win.
Yeah, that because I don't know how to skate and I really don't want to go hiking with you. So I don't want to go to a movie now. So I guess I'm picking beach day and ice cream.
Yep. Outdoors and ice cream.
Yeah.
Discussed, but you know, these are some good other options. I also appreciated that he included an other option so I could suggest my own. Then
So he gave her an other also so she can write in what she thinks would be good.
Food I liked. I honestly clicked all of the options because I'm not a very good at picking food. Where am I then?
Yeah, so that's good. She can pick from Indian, Thai food, burgers, steak.
I think they should have that for all couples. Like, early in the day, you sent your significant other, your partner, whoever, you know, what food would you like to eat tonight? Mm-hmm. You know, Indian, Thai, Japanese, diner, Italian.
Vegetarian,
and that way they
whatever.
Click on it. Right. They can click on it, think about it and click on it. That way, when they get home, you don't have that conversation of what do you want for dinner? Where should we eat? I don't feel like having that. You don't have to do that. It's decided early in the day. Every day that goes out to your sig other and they click what they want, and they can even any kind of menu at a Holiday Inn or something, you know, click your drink. Do you want to have a beer? Do you want to have soda? Are you feeling like alcohol tonight? Or you just want something a little cash? Do you know what I mean? And even like sex afterwards, too tired, long day.
You know? I don't think you know that yet. That should come later. On a scale of what we should wear for the date, pajamas, active wear, everyday casual, or suit and tie.
Fancy schmanciness from 1 to 5. I just picked everyday casual because I didn't want it to be too fancy, but you know, I appreciated the option. He would have shown up.
I love the pajamas option.
Who wouldn't choose pajamas, I'm wondering?
No, so far you and I are in our pajamas going to the beach.
An address if I had selected it, I'm certain. And then at the bottom, he asked if there was anything he should know, and I included a disclaimer that anything he doesn't say can and will be used in a future ticket.
So Graham is a guy without a car. Will you drive, yes or no? I love that.
And he agreed. So here we are.
Cooper's a girl without a car. Apparently we're a perfect fit.
So they went out on the date, and then following the date, she gets more.
The city that he lives in, he sent me this
So we sent her an invitation to the dinner and a movie. What time? Arrival. He sent that to her phone.
Fancy invitation to the date. Please find attached a casual invitation. I said, wow, so casual. What an honor to receive such an invitation. Super casual. We went out on said date. It was lovely. Uh-huh. And then he followed it up by sending me an exit interview that I never actually filled out. So here's my answers. Exit survey, date night. In the interest of professionalism and giving dating the structure and administrative bureaucracy it is always deserved, Graham has requested you fill it. It was optional exit survey. I see you as optional.
Optional,
fill it out.
Yeah.
But here you go. On you a scale of awkward to charming, how would you rate Graham's performance? One
how would you rate his performance? Awkward to charming.
That's fantastic.
You know, I would say it's probably like a 4, not because of his specifically awkwardness, but there was awkwardness because it's a first date and that's just how it goes. At any point in our date, did you experience the following symptoms?
like nausea, discomfort, fear of the abyss, butterflies, tinnitus, tinnitus. Heartburn, exhilaration, and that upset stomach. That's hilarious.
Foot pain.
Yeah. Sure.
Cared for, heard. Oh, that's so nice. Heard. I really felt heard.
That he included
brain fog.
Loss of taste or smell.
Loss of taste or smell is good.
Yeah, he knew that she just had COVID, so that's why he put that in there.
What words might you use in a future song or TikTok to describe your experience? There you go. These are the words. It was really nice. Any further comments? This is hilarious. Anyways, long story short, I'm dating someone now, long distance, and that's fun. You may all go stalk him if you'd like. Tag him in the comments below.
Yeah, so he went through all that, and now she's dating somebody else.
Right. Well, look, he gave her a laugh. You know, I have to say, like, okay, so normally when you said there was going to be a Google questionnaire, I thought it was going to be somebody that who was told ahead of time, like, you know, get consent, you know, or, you know, like a serious thing. He's a prankster. That's funny. He's got a great sense of humor. Women like funny guys. I mean, that's why all these hot women are going after Pete Davidson. It's certainly not his looks. So clearly funny works. I'm down with that. I like the idea if it's funny. I don't like the idea if you're trying to be serious.
Okay, so you're taking this guy as cute, not psycho.
If I was single and I swiped on him and I received that, I would think that was hilarious. I'd be like, oh my God, this guy is so much fun. This is going to be a great date.
In our pajamas at the beach with ice cream.
That, you know what? He gave me the option. I love the idea of showing up in my pajamas or pajamas at the movies. Like whatever you want to do. I don't care. Dinner. How about this? The fanciest restaurant possible in our pajamas. Go. Like that's awesome. I love that guy.
And if he shows up and she shows up, you got to go get married. If you show up in your pajamas while you're going to the Palm. I mean, come on. You're perfect
for each
other.
Well, let's not take it that far. Hang on a minute. No.
You're perfect for each other if you show up in your
pajamas. Getting ahead of yourself here.
Oh,
no.
I'm sorry.
We interrupt this program.
Are you listening?
Did you hear it?
It's the Cooper and Anthony Show.
You've heard of this?
Yeah.
It's cool.
Dear God, here we go.
Just because a celebrity is famous doesn't mean they are popular.
Right, that's true.
So I'm going to give you singers. You got to tell me who is more popular.
Oh, good. I love this. Okay.
So you got to pick, and I got to click on which one you think is more popular. So The first one is Ariana Grande and Taylor Swift.
Ooh, that's tough. I think, it is tough because I'll tell you why. More popular, I would say, is probably, wow, that is hard because I know Taylor, the Swifties, but then Ariana Grande has her fans too.
And Ariana is on The Voice now.
Right.
She's got a new line of makeup coming out. There's a lot of things going around her right now. So
right.
I look at these by if they're walking in the airport, mm-hmm. who is stopping traffic?
But does it go by how many Instagram followers? Like,
No.
About...
I'm just saying how you feel. Who is more popular?
I feel like Taylor Swift is more accessible and it's more exciting to see Ariana Grande, because I feel like Taylor Swift, I can just call her and she'll come over. Ariana Grande is like seeing her in the wild is like, what? So,
yeah, because I think Taylor, if she's walking down the airport, I'm going, that's a hot blonde. Mm-hmm. But Ariana Grande, you know who that is.
So who's more popular?
I don't know. That's a rough one. Who are you going with?
I'm
going
to say, I know it's tough because they both have lots of hit songs. You know, Taylor is a real feminist and she's been getting people to vote and talking about taking her music back from Scooter Braun and re-releasing Red. And, oh, man, who's more popular? I'm going to say Taylor Swift just because Ariana Grande is only one type of music. Taylor has done pop and country and has more fans around the world.
All right. Ariana Grande got 44%. Taylor got 56%.
Okay.
So you were right.
Taylor Swift.
All right. Mm-hmm. Who's more popular? Olivia Rodrigo. Harry Styles.
Oh, Harry Styles.
Harry Styles. You're going with Harry.
Of course, Harry Styles. I'm not even, there's no question Harry Styles.
Yeah. 87% go to Harry. So you're right. Justin Bieber, Billie Eilish.
Ooh, that's hard.
Yeah, that's a hard one.
Yeah. It's hard because Justin Bieber's been around a long time. He's got a lot of fans, but Billie Eilish is like, she's shiny new keys. She's amazing. Mm-hmm. People love her. You know, I think that Justin, every time he puts out a song, it goes right to number one. He has features all over the place. His music has been really important. But I think right now in this moment, it's Billie Eilish.
Wow. Close. 51% Bieber, 49% Billie Eilish. So you're close.
Wow. Okay.
All right. Who's more famous? This is easy. Beyonce, Ed Sheeran.
I know it's Ed Sheeran.
You're going to say Ed Sheeran?
Yeah. I mean, I want it to be Beyonce because you know how I feel about this. Like Beyonce to me is the queen. She's a goddess and everything she does is perfect. But, you know, like Ed Sheeran has been his concerts, his tour made more money than any concert, any tour. When it comes to hit songs, he had way more hits than Beyonce, even though we love her more. You know, I mean, she's the queen, but, you know, he's the pop star right now.
And he did really well on Saturday Night Live. Really
right.
Well. Yeah. I'm going to go against you on this one. I'm going to pick Beyonce.
Okay.
And I was right. 82% to Ed Sheeran's 18.
Oh, 18?
18%.
Well, I have to say, like, I'm really happy to hear that because you and I both love Beyonce. And we, you know, Ed Sheeran's okay. Like, he's a really nice guy, but his music is not really our, we're like, whatever.
No, I'll prove it to you right now. I have Ed Sheeran's phone number. I don't have Beyonce's phone number.
Right. That's a good point. So, nor would you ever. Yeah.
Yeah. Whose phone number is in my phone? Ed Sheeran or Beyonce?
No, I'm happy to hear that. But I will tell you that a lot of my gays really hate Beyonce, which is why I was thinking... They don't love Ed Sheeran, but they like Ed Sheeran. They really hate Beyonce.
Mm-hmm. No, I got his number. So,
okay.
Rihanna or Shawn Mendes?
Oh, Rihanna.
Rihanna, 100%.
Of course.
Yeah, Rihanna, 89%. Shawn Mendes, 11.
Right. Shawn Mendes had like a hit and a half. Rihanna, not only is she... like boot up with ASAP Rocky, who is also like a god, like the two of them are the perfect couple. But she has her Fenty line of lingerie and makeup. And she's about to blow Kim Kardashian out of the water. Mm. Rihanna is already a billionaire because of all that stuff. Everyone loves her. Nobody does not like Rihanna.
Yeah, we walked past Shawn Mendes and went, I think that's Shawn Mendes. You know, right. We would have walked past Rihanna and said, that's Rihanna. 100%.
Right. Yeah.
All right, this is a hard one. Katy Perry, Dua Lipa.
That is a hard one, and you and I have discussed this because Katy Perry's music has not been doing well. Her last album bombed. But she is... very well paid for American Idol. You know, she
married to somebody very famous.
Married to Orlando Bloom. She's, I mean, I know Dua Lipa does better musically. Her music sells better. But that's just a,
not
you know,
if you
that's
go back
an
and look at the catalog. If you look at the catalog, it's Katy Perry.
Right, right, I guess. It's got to be Katy Perry.
Yeah, Katy Perry. Katy Perry, 66%, Dua Lipa, 34%.
Okay.
This is a hard one. No, this isn't a hard one. The next one's a hard one. Adele, Demi Lovato.
Oh, Adele.
Adele. Yeah, Adele, 91%.
Of course, there you go. Demi who?
Yeah.
Man, yeah, that's unfair.
All right, this one's hard. The Weeknd, Post Malone.
Ooh, that one is
hard.
Yeah,
that's a hard one.
Huh. I prefer Post Malone, but I think people taking this survey would probably say The Weeknd. Remember, his music is always in the top. So is Post Malone's music. But
yeah, Post Malone. I don't know. I mean, The Weeknd, he did the halftime show. Kind of people know he is.
Right. He might be dating Angelina Jolie right now. We're not quite sure. They're not copping to it. The only reason I'm going to say The Weeknd is because his music is more accessible. Like, older people and younger people like his music. Post Malone is a very specific taste that's basically our generation and younger.
Who's walking down the airport? Who are you noticing?
Well, of course, I'm noticing Post Malone. His face is tattooed.
Yeah, we'll see The Weeknd. The Weeknd, 67%. This is easy, but oof. Britney Spears, Mariah Carey.
Oh, man.
Yeah, that's a hard one.
That's a really hard one, because I would. That's going to be one of those like 49%, 51%.
Yeah, and I think Mariah would jump off the roof if you didn't pick her. I don't think Britney would care. But on the other hand, I think Britney, in the past decade, has been hotter than Mariah.
Free Britney.
Yeah, let's go Britney. Ooh, 79% Britney.
Wow, 79. I thought it was going to be like 51, 49.
No, 79 to 21, Mariah Carey. She's
what?
Not like,
you're kidding.
Yeah, Britney Spears got 16,000 votes. Mariah got 4,000.
Whoa. Ah, don't tell Mariah Carey. She'll kill whoever did this survey. She'll kill them.
All right, this is a hard one. John Legend, Kelly Clarkson.
Oh, Kelly Clarkson. That's not a hard one at all.
Yeah, 59 to 41. John Legend won.
Oh, really?
Yeah, 11,600 votes to 8,000 votes for Kelly Clarkson.
Oh, I mean, the Kelly Clarkson show is doing really, really well. I thought people just loved her.
No, I mean, ratings-wise, it's not. I mean, it's a filler show. So, no, John Legend, really.
Okay.
I mean, who's more talented? I don't know. I mean, they're both very talented, so.
You can't compare their talent. They have two completely different talents and do completely different things. He is a singer-songwriter who plays the piano. She is a hired gun singer. I mean, she does write some of her
voice.
Who has an amazing voice, like one of the great pop voices, I think, of our generation. But
I mean, when John Legend did Jesus Christ Superstar, it was great. You know, that's why I look at him and go, he might be the bigger star.
But I feel like your mom likes John Legend. You know, I don't own any of his music. You and I make fun of him. We think that every song he writes is about like begging Chrissy Teigen not to leave him.
And thank you for sleeping with me.
Right, right.
All right, here's a hard one. This is going to take you a while. You got to talk this one through.
Okay.
And one of them will be very upset if they don't win. Lady Gaga, Kanye West.
I thought you were going to say Lady Gaga, Madonna, because that's usually the comparison.
No, we're going late. We're going to make it hard for you. Lady Gaga, Kanye West.
Well, you and I always support Lady Gaga no matter what. You know, she won the Oscar. Remember, she sang at the inauguration. Like,
true.
Right. Kanye didn't. Kanye has been getting all kinds of, he's been dragged like crazy. He has one battle after another with somebody else. You know, he's one feud after another. As much as I loved Kanye's music. After he went completely batshit, even I stepped away from him a little bit.
But whose music are you still going to listen to in 20 years?
Right. It's for me that it's Kanye.
It's Kanye.
But you're asking who's more popular?
In the Cooper Lawrence world, who are you picking?
Who is more popular? Lady Gaga. People got very upset with Kanye because of his Trump support and all of his political stuff and the fact that he went crazy and he drove Kim Kardashian away.
Yep. 83% Lady Gaga.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah. Only 3,000 votes for Kanye. That's got to drive him. After this has come out, Kanye and Mariah are going to jump off the roof together.
Right, exactly.
All right.
They're going to be tweeting like crazy about it.
Queen, the Beatles.
That's so not of the genres you've been talking about.
I know,
that's
why I threw you a curveball at the end, because Queen, look how big they are now because of the movie, because they're in commercials, but the Beatles are the Beatles. So all these people that answered these questions, who are they going to say?
I think they're going to say Queen because unpopular opinion over here, but I hate the Beatles. And I think there's a lot of people that are closet Beatle haters like I am. I mean, I'm not into boy bands. That's just my thing.
Every time.
But
Queen's a boy band too. You could put it that way.
Not at all. No, they're a rock band. So I'm going to say Queen is more popular.
The Beatles, 59%, Queen, 41%. So it's close.
Yeah, it's close, but it's wrong.
Where are the voices? I don't hear the voices. The Cooper and Anthony Show.
People have been getting vaccinated more and more because they're starting to see people around them getting sick, and they're starting to get more information from their doctors rather than from their aunt on Facebook. So vaccination rates around the world are going up, but there are some little pockets where it's just not budging. So there's this one area of Australia that they're having a real problem getting people to get vaccinated. So they found a way to get people to get vaccinated. A brothel has said, okay, if you get the coronavirus vaccine, you can have one free fling with any prostitute of your choosing.
Now, that beats Krispy Kreme's ass.
Right.
Krispy Kreme, you just got a donut.
Yeah. So I was wondering what you thought of this because, okay, so here's the thing. No, listen, in Australia, so they're saying 14 and over can come to the brothel. You get they have doctors there, nurses there. You get vaccinated there. And then so they give you one jab and then you can give one of their girls a jab.
So it's a one-stop shop.
Yeah.
Get it and got it.
Right. What do you think?
I'm against giving people rewards for doing something that you should do anyway.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's to the point now I'm so sick of this country being so divided.
Right.
Over one freaking thing.
No, the world. This is Australia.
I know, but I'm saying here in the States, it's right. Very either one way or you're the other way. There's no middle ground. And we have a quarterback in the States who didn't get the COVID vaccine and lied about it. And people are just jumping on him or, you know, praising him. And it's crazy that he lied to everybody saying, oh, I got the vaccine. But he's in the huddle every Sunday screaming at these guys, spitting on them. They have no idea. So stop it getting free things, getting money to do something that you should do to save somebody's life, maybe even your own. You should get the shot because you want to save your family, save your life, save your kids.
What's so funny is they bring in 14-year-olds. They would say to them, just so you know, you're 14. The minute the prostitute walks in, whatever happens, it's going to go so fast that it's going to take less time than the actual jab.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
like a 14-year-old, like they're going to, I mean, that's it. It's going to be over in like 2 seconds. So they're going to be like, you know what? Yours will be, wait till you see. They'll give you a shot. See how fast that was? Now go in the room. I bet it's even faster.
See, and now you got to look at this woman and say, you have to give something for free because this asshole wasn't smart enough to do it himself.
No, they're offering. They're offering as an incentive. The brothel came up with the idea. But see, my thing is this. That wasn't even my issue. Like, I see what you're saying, and I agree with you. Like, there shouldn't be incentive. Like, here in New York, they're offering $100. My bigger issue is, okay, so it's a brothel of women. Okay, so it's good for straight men and lesbian women. Mm-hmm. And that's it. So gay men and straight women, we got nothing for you here.
Right.
So that's really not fair. Like, but you're trying to incentivize everybody, not just lesbians and straight men.
Mm-hmm. Do it because you should. It's the right thing to do, right, to get past this shit and so we can live another year. And some people, like you, can actually leave their house.
You're just mad that there's nobody giving you a free blowjob.
Exactly. I'm getting my third shot Friday. Where's my hand job? I mean, I'm doing it because I don't want to be sick and I don't want to die and I don't want to be in the hospital for 2 months, right, like my sister. So that's right, why I'm doing it. But you got to fight with people nonstop because these people, it's like the quarterback we have here. He's a freaking doctor now.
Right.
You know, I do my own research. Shut the fuck up. If you do your own research, then you know what? Quit the NFL and be a researcher.
Right. Exactly. If you do your own research, then you should have a doctor become a quarterback.
No, he said, I'm going with Joe Rogan. I talked to Joe Rogan. You talk to a fucking podcaster.
I get advice from my makeup artist. So, like, you know, if I'm not feeling well, I'm going to call her.
Yeah. Why not? No, the problem is I talk to people every day and they go, no, I do my own research. You didn't graduate high school. What grade did you get in science class? What grade? I failed science. So I'm not taking my advice.
Right.
You know, at least you went to like 16, 17 grades. I'm going to probably listen to you more than I listen to the guy that barely, like me, made it out of high school.
And I, who has a PhD, would never even dream of giving medical advice because I'm not a doctor.
But you are a PhD. You're more than Joe Rogan. Joe Rogan is on the same level as I am. Right. We talk into the same mic. We do the same thing. You're going to listen to Joe Rogan and not a doctor.
Yeah, no, that does. When he's put it that way, it does seem really stupid. But even that, it's like I keep seeing people tweeting about this, and it's like, okay, so if you don't believe in science, you don't believe in doctors, then what? Then if you ever get sick, don't go to a doctor. Like, why would you? Either you trust doctors or you don't. You can't pick and choose when you go to a doctor. So
what happens when these people get cancer and the doctor says, we have to give you chemo? Do they say, I'm going to take horse pills?
They call Joe Rogan.
They call Joe Rogan.
I have testicular cancer, Joe.
Yeah, just like Nicki Minaj's cousin's younger brother's.
Right. Exactly.
Yeah, so no incentives, you get nothing. You know what? You get to live. There's your incentive. That's the best incentive ever.
A journey back in time.
The Cooper and Anthony Show.
Oh, that takes me back.
So now this weekend, I had a very interesting weekend this weekend. My girlfriend Stephanie, I've known her for many, many, many years. And Heidi, do you have friends that...
No.
None. Okay.
A, not talking to you. Is your name Heidi over there?
Sorry.
No, that's Heidi over there. When I say Heidi, I'm talking to her.
That's me.
So, Anthony, seriously, really, zip it. Anyway, Heidi, do you have friends where, again, no one's talking to you? Heidi, can you do something about him? Make him be quiet. You're a mom. What's your tactic?
I'll give him the stare.
Let's give him the stare.
Wow.
Leer.
Oh,
wow. The double leer.
I got that look all weekend.
Yeah, you're going to keep getting it if you don't button your lip.
Okay, sorry.
Okay. Anyway, Heidi, what I want to know from you is, do you have friends where you like them very much, you know them socially, but you don't get a chance to really spend enough one-on-one time with them, but you know when you do, you're going to really like each other?
Yes.
Yeah, and only because your life's busy and their life's busy, and it's not like we're young kids anymore that we can just like go, oh my God, like crash at each other's house or have slumber parties.
Right, you just don't have that kind of time to dig into a friendship anymore.
Yeah, and it's a shame because you let very good friendships go by the wayside. You don't mean to, but it's just a matter of time, especially you with two children.
Yes. Yep.
So my friend Stephanie is kind of like that. I've known her probably about maybe almost 10 years now. And we've hung out at parties. We've hung out socially with groups, but we haven't really done the one-on-one thing yet. And we keep meaning to because we like each other very much and we talk on the phone a lot. Well, as it turns out, this weekend, Sean Lee had to go to his other family. I guess, you know, his other wife was jealous that he was spending too much time with me or something. I don't know. So Sean Lee's off with his other family. I'm by myself for the weekend. And for the first time in, like, I don't know how long, I actually have nothing to do. I mean, I could have busied myself with stuff, but I had nothing to do. And my girlfriend...
Done staring at the wall.
I was done staring at the wall. And my girlfriend Stephanie has just kind of broken up with somebody, so she's not in a relationship right now. We thought, you're free, I'm free. Oh my God, slumber party! So I go running over to her house with my pajamas, of course. We decide we're not leaving the house for the whole week, and we get into our pajamas the minute I get there. We basically like went out and got food and just like spent the weekend. Did each other's makeup. Actually, she did do my eyebrows.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, she's good. She's like the eyebrow whisperer. She's really good. But here's the thing. Now, because I've always known her, known that she's a lovely person, you don't really get to know somebody until you go to their house and start spending a lot of time with them. And what dawned on me this weekend is Stephanie is nice Cooper. Oh. She and I have so much in common, but she's the nicer version of me.
You're so lucky you found someone like that.
Well, it made me realize that I am evil Cooper.
Oh, well, that's probably not true, but...
Well, no, no, because as we were talking, we found that we were both in similar relationships. And I was like, oh, I treat my husband like this, and I told him this, and I told him that. She's like, ooh, I would have never said that to, you know, her ex. I would never have said that to Joey. No, never. Instead, I told him, and it was like this lovely, sweet, loving thing.
Yeah, but they're broke up, and you're married.
Well, they broke up for other reasons. Oh. But and anyway, so I'm walking around her apartment, and she has, like, she has everything that I have, but the nicer version of it. You know, mm-hmm. And she has all this, but
the nicer,
like,
TV
and a much big plasma screen TV.
Aww.
Yeah. Same brand, same make, but she has like the next same thing. I mean, everything, like her bed was the same bed I have, but like the bigger, nicer version, her clothes, her and all these gifts people gave
Not
her
nicer
and
shoes.
Well, no, it's the only area that I excel in, that I over excel in. But, you know, I even like it was funny because one of our mutual friends had called on the phone. And whenever I talk to this friend of ours, it's always kind of like a... I've always found this friend of ours to be a little bit on the hostile side. So whenever I talk to her, I'm always like a little bit kind of, you know, I'm nice, but, you know, I'm a little short with her because I just, I don't know. She's one of these people that, for me, I don't have a lot of patience for her. Not Stephanie. Stephanie was, oh, tell me what's going on, sweetie. What's on your... Stephanie was, and I was like, isn't she a little annoying? She's like, yeah, but I don't care. She's so sweet. I baked her cookies last week. Stephanie is nice me. She basically, you know, does similar things for a living, but people like her more in our industry. You know what I mean?
Can she do this show? Can I work for her? That would be great. It's not that I don't like you, but can I work for her?
Well, she does TV stuff. She does local TV stuff. But, you know, it's similar in the way that she's in the entertainment business as well.
Darn
you know
it.
What I mean? But she's really likable and has all these friends, whereas me, not so much. And it was like every place we went, you know, we went out for dinner one night. And and even like the way the waitress walked over and said to her, hey, how are you? What do you want to drink? Oh, okay. And then turned on her heels and walked away. Did not even ask me what
Spit
I wanted
on
to
you.
Drink. Spit on me. Did not even ask what I wanted to drink.
What would you like?
The waitress comes back over with Stephanie's drink, goes, sorry to bother you. Can my friend have something too? And I was like, you know, yeah, B word.
I don't see anybody there.
Yeah, really? But like,
who is it you speak of?
But the more I spoke with her and the more similarities we seemed to have in our personality, the more freaked out I got. I mean, just even the way she carries herself and the way she keeps her apartment, she's nice me. It's a parallel universe. I finally found the parallel universe where I'm nice. Except it's Stephanie and not me.
Well, see, maybe you can learn some things from her.
I know.
See, that's your next book.
What?
Learn things from her.
Actually, no. When I was in Minneapolis, I came up with my next book title.
Oh, no. What is this?
Show Me Your Boobs and Go Home.
And you learned that in Minneapolis.
Well, I was talking to some new friends in Minneapolis about like our past and about how, you know, I've been treated in the past as a woman. And basically I said, you know, they basically like just show me your boobs and get out of here.
You would sell a lot of books to men and women.
Show me your boobs and go home?
Right. Mm-hmm. The men would buy it because
of the
cover. I would
actually read that book.
Yeah. I don't even need anything inside of it. Actually, you know, here's the book.
That book needs pictures.
But here's the book. It's just pictures of boobs.
Oh.
That's all this is, pictures of boobs, different types of boobs that women have at different stages of their life and stuff like that, like a whole chronology of boobs.
Sounds like a coffee table hit.
That is brilliant.
I think so, too. I could make a fortune. Show me your boobs and go home.
Right. You could just have a line of women just come in. The boobies, click, click, and off they go.
But I wouldn't do it in a flash your boobie kind of way. It wouldn't be in like a wet t-shirt contest kind of
no,
way.
No, they would come in and go, click, 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 yeah. sign a release, and off they go.
They'd be tasteful art pictures. I would get like some really creative black and white photograph artist guy in to take pictures.
No, it has to be like on somebody's shoulders at a Motley Crue concert type of photo.
Oh, maybe a whole bunch of them then. Maybe
it could be
some
different.
Like that. Yeah, some like that. Some like cute little Polaroids.
Right.
I got to hook up with a photographer and see about this.
Well, I'm pretty sure we'll find one pretty quick.
Brock, I better get this book together immediately.
I'm calling to place my pre-order for this book right now.
Now, would you buy this, Brock?
I'm calling to place my order for the pre-order for the boob book.
Not in a heartbeat, in a boob beat.
In a boob beat.
Okay, I've sold one book. Thank you
we
very
sold
much,
one
Brock.
Book.
Brock, boob book one.
Right. Thank you, Brock.
Sold.
Sold. And Ken, you're volunteering to be involved with my boob book?
I'll be more than happy to take the pictures.
Oh. Now, are you a photographer, or does that really matter?
I'll even go buy a camera.
I'll even go buy a camera.
I'll buy a good one, too.
A good one?
A real good one. I might spend maybe $50.
Okay, so it's not going to be one of those throwaway cameras. You're actually going to go out and buy a camera that has film in it or a digital or something.
I was going to get one of them digital ones, yeah.
Digital.
You have people going after your job already, Ken.
Ken, look, you got to get yourself a picture machine.
Yeah, because Lee is on the case, too.
Lee, do you have a picture machine?
I sure do. I can print whatever you need.
Oh, wait. Oh. So do you take pictures? Are you a photographer?
Yes, I am.
Seriously? Because we should totally hook up and put this book together.
We should. It's a plan.
No, sir, I'm not even joking. Like, if you're a photographer, I'm interested. 877-6-COOPER is the number. And email me, Cooper at Bob's House of Meat.
Can you send us samples of what it might look like?
No, don't send samples of boobs. I want to see samples of just photographs.
Well, you don't know if they can take good photos of boobs. You have to see what it actually looks like.
Go buy a website. Shut up and buy a website.
Thank you, Lee.
Thank you, Lee. Hey, that would be kind of cool. Warren, are you a photographer?
Oh, yes.
Oh, I didn't know that's what you do. Now, tell me.
Well, it's what I'm a semi-pro, okay?
Ooh.
And I've sold about $2,000 worth of my framed work. I've been in about 4 galleries. I just got in another gallery.
Okay, so what do you think of this idea? Do you think you and I can sell a book called Show Me Your Boobs and Go Home?
Oh, yeah, I might not even need you.
Okay.
But you've got the name, and you're the self-promoter, so yeah, you're in, yeah.
Yeah, see, that's my contribution, that I'm the ideas gal.
Okay, yeah, I don't have any samples of those, but if you want me to, I'll do like a self-portrait.
Yeah, I want to see your boobs, Warren.
Go take photos of Ken's.
Go take photos of Ken's boobs.
Oh, Ken's got nothing on me.
No, I'm telling you, Ken's boobs are way bigger than mine.
Oh, okay. Well, that's really funny because I am a semi-pro photographer, and I'm going, oh, what? I need some work.
I think I just found a job for you, Warren. Right. I think we have a project together.
And somebody took showmeyourboobs.com.
Well, no, because this isn't Show Me Your Boobs. This is a whole different concept. This isn't Show Me Your Boobs. This is, we're doing this. Casey, we should do this, like, artistically, right?
I think so. But I think it's great. It should be, like, a boobology.
Oh, the boobology.
Yeah.
That's good.
I mean, I think it would be amazing. I know two really good photographers that I would put, like, I really, like, I would buy it.
Yeah, I mean, I think it would be an interesting book. I love that everybody's calling about the boob book.
I was thinking, while I was on hold, that I would even be in it, because I'm 30, and my boobs are only heading south, so I might as well get a picture of them now.
Right, get a picture of them now before they get any further down to your knees. Now, Casey, do you remember when this show used to be Smart Talk About Real Life?
It never was.
I think this could be Smart Talk, maybe.
I think it
not
could.
Really.
I'm gonna do a smart version of the boob book. This isn't gonna be. It's not porn. It's not dirty.
It's
artistic.
Not porn. It's different boobs in different scenarios.
Yeah.
Like at a
it's
Motley
like
Crue
boobs,
show.
Boobs in their natural environment.
Oh, that's good.
Brilliant.
Yeah, that's really good. This could be very creative.
That's the name of the book.
What?
Boobs in their natural environment.
No, you do that book. I've already named my book.
Oh, okay.
Show me your boobs and get out, or show me your boobs and go home. I have to figure.
It could be two.
I got to focus group it.
It could be the second book. You could have two solid books.
One of them is Go Home. The other is Get Out.
Right.
But either way, show me your boobs and go out.
Right.
Is that available?
Right. Show me what?
Show me your boobs and get out. Is that available?
That's available.
How about show me your boobs and go home?
That's available too. But boobology is taken.
And so you know what's sad about this? My original intention was that this is going to be my autobiography. Show me your boobs and go home.
This is going to sell. This is going to put you on the top of the number one bestseller.
You think?
Yes. Somebody, it's going to be huge.
Heidi, call my publisher. Tell them we have a brilliant idea. Stop the presses. Nicole, does anybody say stop the presses anymore?
I don't know. I watch old movies all the time, so I hear it all the time.
Okay, good. So they all say it, so that's good. Okay, now, Nicole, do you want to take part in my boob book?
I do. I will volunteer to be the first pair of boobs photographed.
Oh, that's great. I'm glad to know that. Now, what scenario should we put you in?
Well, I was thinking the reason I would do it is because I've always been one of those girls that I hate my boobs. I don't want anybody to see them. I've never flashed. I would never do any of that.
Mm-hmm.
And then I had my daughter, and I, of course, breastfeed my daughter. Now everybody has seen my boobs.
Oh, I see.
So I had to get over that. And, yeah, now they're just boobs. So, I don't know, maybe a breastfeeding picture?
Oh, see, I think that's very artistic. That's good, because that sends the message that boobs could be nourishment and nourishing. It's not just, it's part of the whole evolution, part of the whole nature's process.
Exactly, because people are way too hung up about breastfeeding, and I get dirty looks and everything. It's like, come on, it's just boobs.
Right.
So that way it could, you know, promote that as well.
Okay, I like that, Nicole, because that's an artistic concept. I like that, because I don't want anything like pornographic. Nothing that Anthony would buy.
We could boob it forward.
Is boob it forward available?
Yes.
Okay, go buy that also. Hi, Kathy.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good. I was coming up with a great book idea.
Well, I think this is the hottest topic you've had in a long time from all the response.
It's not even a topic.
It is now.
I know, it's scary, Kathy. What do you think about it?
Well, my first thought was, I have a friend who's a photographer in L.A. He has been a fashion photographer. He now takes a lot of pictures of women in beauty pageants. He would love to be your photographer for this book. He would love it.
Oh, really? Well, tell him, my email, cooper@bobshouseandme. Tell him to email me.
Okay, I will. I will have him send you some of his work. And then my other thought is, I love your title, because everywhere you go, all of these young women have their boobs just out there in their everyday clothes. So they come into meetings and it's there. They come into restaurants. They come into wherever, and their boobs are out there. So yeah, it is. It's like everyone's just showing their boobs and then going home. So I think it's a good one.
Exactly. Thank you, Kathy. Thank you for your support. I appreciate support. It's double entendre, because it's a boob thing with the bra support. You get it?
Send your comments to cooper@boobitforward.com.
Did you buy boob it forward?
No, I'm not buying it.
Hi, Chris.
Hey, how are you?
Now, if we do this boob book, we're going to need to have people on the ground, you know, on foot, marketing the book and selling it. What do you think?
Oh, yeah, that's me.
Yeah?
I'll sell them by the case. I got dorms on hold right now waiting to buy this book. I'm telling you, this is a great idea. I mean, really, it is. I think it's, you know, if you do it classy, I think it'd be a great coffee table book. You know, there's so many books out there that, you know, they have pictures of the earth and the planets and whatnot. Mm-hmm. You know, do something interesting. A pair of boobs is interesting.
And, you know, and I was thinking maybe we can also get a couple of those artists who paint women when they're naked. They paint like clothes in them, but they're really naked.
Absolutely. You can go so many different ways with it as far as being artistic about it. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, this is good, Chris. And Chris, you'll sell this book for us, no problem.
Oh, I could. How much do you want to make on each book? You tell me the price, and then I'll mark it up. I'll make my cut, and we'll all make money.
$10 a book. You sell it for 15. You keep 5.
Sell it for 15.
Yep.
Nah, you guys are charging too little for it.
People pay good money for boobs.
I guess so. Hi, Tom.
Hi. How you doing?
So, Tom, please contribute to my boob book.
Well, to touch on what you just said, you know, about having artist renditions. Of course, you got painters. But you also have sketch artists and, well, even my forte, comic book artists as well.
Oh, that's brilliant. Oh, Tom, that's good. Tom, are you a comic book artist?
No, but my friend Bobby, he did a couple of small things for a small magazine. And, of course, I'm a comic book enthusiast. You know, one good artist you could think of using, his name is Jim Lee. He did a lot of work for Marvel.
Oh, he's famous. I can't afford him.
Right.
I need some hack who can draw a couple of boobs for me.
We need to go to the police station and get an artist. What does the boob look like? It was about this big. And
it had a nipple.
It was just like round. No. Erase that. It was different than that. It was more droopy.
It was more droopy than that. There you go.
A police sketch artist.
We need a sketch artist. Police sketch artist.
That would be a whole chapter. We'll explain
a whole chapter of a bunch of men describing like the first boob they ever saw to a police sketch artist.
Exactly, and then them. This is
brilliant.
Huge. We don't even need a publisher. We just need a copy machine and people with cameras and some staple guns, and we'll do our own book.
Oh my God, this is smart talk about big boobs.